Hi, everyone. Alongside Mike Trosel, I'm Dave Giancola, and welcome back for another episode of A Champion's Journey. Perhaps nobody was more motivated to win the 1999 U.S. Open than Payne Stewart. After winning the championship in 1991, he was so close to a second U.S. Open trophy in 1998, but he finished runner-up to Lee Jansen.
And Stewart once again made his presence felt atop the leaderboard at Pinehurst No. 2. After 54 holes, he was in the pole position, leading by one stroke. His primary challenger, budding superstar Phil Mickelson, who had the added drama of a wife expecting their first child at a moment's notice. And two strokes back, well, the legend himself, Tiger Woods, then searching for his first U.S. Open win.
Some stiff competition at the top of the leaderboard, but Payne Stewart, he would deliver on golf's biggest stage. Here it is, every televised shot of Stewart's incredible victory in 1999.
Payne Stewart, his second.
That from the left rough, and one of the players whose chances I really like this week. Outstanding iron player, outstanding short game player. And that's something you don't see often, a play from the rough to the green on a U.S. Open golf course.
Well, we talked to David Duvall with an opening round of 67. Now we welcome Phil Mickelson, also with a 67. Phil, congratulations on that. But first of all, more important things, the beeper and the cellular phone still silent today.
They were. My wife's carrying a beeper around. She's expecting here in the next 2 weeks. And although the doctor says it probably won't come until the due date of June 30th, yeah, you never can tell on these things. And I'm very fortunate because as soon as that beeper goes off, I'm headed to the airport.
And you're saying no matter what, you keep stacking up 67s and it happens later, say maybe sometime on Sunday, you go home?
If that beeper goes off, I'm out of here. I think that as important as the U.S. Open is to me and every player in it, there's a U.S. Open every year, but this is the birth of my first child, and I just wouldn't miss out for the world.
Phil, always a lot of talk when you arrive at a major championship venue. When will Phil Mickelson win his first major championship? Tell us how you felt going into previous majors and the different kind of feeling you've come into this championship having just arrived late Tuesday. Totally different.
Well, I got in Tuesday night and took a look at the golf course Wednesday, and I couldn't be more excited about this U.S. Open. I think that the setup of this year's U.S. Open tests every shot in your bag. In the past years, off the tee, driver wasn't really an issue. But this year, at 240 yards off the tee, the fairway is the same width as it is at 320 yards. So everybody in the field can hit any club they want up to and including driver. And around the greens, the short game has been pretty much obsolete in past U.S. Opens. But this year, it's an intricate part of the game, and there's a lot of emphasis played on the little short shots played around the green. So I couldn't be any more excited about the setup for the golf course and this year's U.S. Open.
Well, let's check out some of your play today. Opened with a front nine 34 and then caught fire here at 13. This for birdie.
Just tried to cozy this one down the hill, and it just kind of snuck in the left edge.
And then you followed that up with another birdie at 14.
This was just a little left to right putt, and it just set up perfect.
And you par at 15, 16, 17. This was a big putt for par at 18.
It was a right edge putt. Just there at the end, it moved enough left to fall in. I hit a poor chip from just left of the green. It was a little tight lie, and I was thinking about either putting it or using an 8-iron. I ended up using an L wedge, and it spun a little too much, checked up.
Well, Phil, you're known for your imagination around the greens. I would imagine you were smacking your lips when you got to take a look at this number two course and see those areas where maybe you might have an advantage. Would you think you might?
Well, Roger, I think that there are a lot of top players that have great short games, and Duvall's short game is exceptional, as is Tiger's. But what I was really excited about was the opportunity to have that short game be an integral part of the competition, whereas in the past, it was if you missed the green, you were just struggling to make par or bogey. Where here, if you miss a green, although it's a very difficult up and down, it's possible. You have a lie and you have a shot. You just have to create it.
Well, Phil, thanks for joining us. Congratulations on your round today. And also a belated happy birthday. You turned 29 on Wednesday.
I did. I'm getting up there. Thanks.
Good luck the rest of the weekend with everything, Phil. Par four second. And this is Payne Stewart and a birdie chance.
Should leak a little to his right. I don't know if he pushed that or misread it, but never on the right line.
To the third. This is a birdie attempt for Payne Stewart.
Back uphill, slow putt. plenty of speed. And Stewart, former Open champion,
is fourth, the par five. 91 champion Payne Stewart eyeing this putt for a birdie. Putting back down the hill, so will be some speed. Although the moisture really has taken some of the fear out of these greens. The players telling me yesterday that they felt the pace had increased some foot or foot and a half on the stemp meter from Tuesday's practice round. But greens just now at a comfortable speed, I think they would say. Stewart went to this putter early in the year and, of course, won the AT&T Pro-Am and has had a couple of runner-up finishes, so a good season for him.
Hasn't really done much in the Open. Seven previous appearances, best finish, tie for 23rd in 92.
This ball up on the surface at one time, now a good 10 feet off the green. Look at this elevation change up a steep slope here.
Beautiful play by Mayfair. And that will be his best opening round in a U.S. Open by a couple of shots. Par is 70 here, but Mayfair will join Duvall and Mickelson in the clubhouse with a 67 of his own.
Well, Billy really kind of a streaky putter, but when he gets on that hot streak, it can last for a while. He has prolonged periods where he doesn't putt very well, but when he gets it going, he can keep it going for weeks.
Bad putt to six, the par three, Payne Stewart. He's at minus one.
Yeah, well, that's Dave. We saw Greg Norman's ball come off from just about the same location.
We'll go to the 17th.
Paul Goitis, four birdie at 17. To get to three under. And that drops in. Goitis with three birdies on the back nine.
Go up to 18.
Paul Goitis, birdie putt on the way. And it will be an outstanding opening round for Goitis. And we don't want to get too far ahead of ourselves, but he will turn 35 years old on Sunday, Roger, Father's Day. And what a moment that would be for he and his wife Wendy, two girls, Chelsea and Courtney.
But now at the 11th, his second shot.
Right there. Stay right there.
Back left hole location. Oh my goodness. What a way to come back. I bet he's going to make that one.
Third shot for Payne Stewart on this 610-yard par 5.
Tough left hole location, one under par. Great start through nine. Delicate shot right here. Oh, and he stiffs it. What a shot.
And a birdie chance for Stewart to go two under. Bogey free thus far. And at the par 5 10th, this is Payne Stewart's short putt for birdie. And Stewart to two under for the championship. 211, second shot at this par 4 for Payne Stewart, currently two under.
Just loves the U.S. Open, doesn't he, Dick?
Yes, he does.
He gears his, I think, a whole year around this championship. I really do. It's just, it's friendly confines for him. The way he really has not played that well this year. He's well over 100 in driving accuracy, well over 100 in greens hit and regulation. And he comes here and he looks like he's David Duvall. See him looking out to the right there, going across the green. He's moving left. Looks pretty good if he hits it.
Stewart will stay at two under for the championship.
Second shot for Payne Stewart. Right hand rough. Appeared to be a decent lie. Want to just try to land the ball around the front of the green and have it release up.
Pretty smart shot on Gary.
That's a very well played shot. And this now Payne Stewart with a birdie putt. The par 4 12th.
currently minus two.
But you have to be a little careful with, as everything moves away if it gets past the hole, and he recognizes that, comes up a little short, but back to 13. Second shot, Payne Stewart. Short par four up the hill. Oh man, what was that? Johnny, that
I think that was what you call, that was called Sod City there. You just don't, let's take a look at this thing. Let's take it here, you watch his head, see if anything moves there. Stand pretty good right there, raises up there, and then he releases a little early and he hangs back on that back foot. See how the right heel is late to get off the ground? He just never got off his right foot till after impact.
And the third shot now for Payne Stewart, not an easy one. Green sits well up above the level of the fairway. Did he put a little spin on it? Well, he'll bring it back a little bit. Payne Stewart, downhill putt for a par after that chunky second shot. Should move a little to his right. Oh, how about that save?
That was an unusual par.
To say the least.
Payne Stewart off the green. This is his third shot.
Look at this shot.
Nicely done. He saves his par and remains two under, just one off the lead.
Johnny, this is a five iron. I would think he's got to catch all of this to even get to the center of the green.
Seems like he's hardly hit a green in regulation, and here he's sitting there at minus two.
Yeah, hang, okay.
Good shot.
Just over the false front of this green, so a safe play onto the putting surface. Birdie putt for Payne Stewart. Chance to move into that log jam at three under. Ooh, it should move a little right. Oh, is this guy putting his ball or what?
When's the last time you saw him two putt a hole?
It's been a while, Johnny.
Going with a six iron. 93 yards. It's not a big six for him. He swings sort of smoothly, which is nice to see. And that's not very good, Tiger. When's the last time you see the guy back it up? And he's right in there, Tiger Woods, even par going to one under maybe, and he loves it.
Duvall, Mickelson, Stewart, Mayfair, Goidos in the clubhouse, 3 under. Daly at the 12th is minus three. Terrific leaderboard, and this the 99th U.S. Open Championship from beautiful Pinehurst, North Carolina.
He's coming off six pars in a row, and there you go, broke the par string.
And Tiger Woods, who had an indifferent round, front nine, nevertheless is at minus one and very much a part of the early story of this 99th U.S. Open Championship. There's his scorecard.
It has a lot of difference psychologically to a player between 70 and 69. Being in red figures, being in the 60s, there's something about being in the 60s a lot different. And the last hole.
It's Payne Stewart's second shot at the 16th, Dick. Trying to skate a two iron up there as he's yelling at it. And that has been a popular spot here at 16. Just short, leaves a reasonable pitch.
Going in with just a, looks like a wedge or nine iron, and of course the right hole location. Taking dead aim, see if he can hit a good short iron. Online, right distance for Tiger. He's got backboards. See if it stays. Okay, good shot.
Now a chance for birdie at 18 for Woods that would take him to two under. Just one from the lead. Let's go back to 16.
Payne Stewart playing his third shot at the par four. And we see with the putter, Tiger Woods from a similar position, used the three wood. So you see all the options available to the players.
Gotta give it a whack, don't you, from here?
Well, especially with the putter you do, coming up over the ridge.
You see that ball just totally went airborne, which I think was good. It got it sort of popped it up over the fringe.
Now a tap in for Stewart to stay at three under.
And a good par four at 16.
He's a magician, Gary. I mean,
well,
really.
Johnny, you look at the statistics. He's 123rd in greens hit and regulation. He's 134th in driving accuracy, and he's already made over $1.2 million this year on tour. He chips and putts real well.
When things aren't quite going right, but he just the guy's just good. He never misses a cut. I mean, he's always there, even when things aren't going real good. And the only thing that's really been Achilles' heel is when you have long rough involved. And that's why he's probably pretty happy coming here to Pinehurst. Not much break here.
And that'll broaden the smile. A 68 for Tiger Woods, one from the lead.
Great finish, just a perfect finish.
Welcome back. One of the men sharing the lead is at 17, Payne Stewart.
193 yards, back right hole location. And somebody said, go in the hole.
Well done. Stewart with a chance for the outright lead. And the way he's been putting, well, four times Payne Stewart has led after the first round of the United States Open. He won the title in 91, thought he should have won it last year. Was not happy with that final round.
He's got that great ability for chipping and getting up and in. Today, through 16 holes, he's got 21 putts, folks. I mean, give me a break. He's going on 22 now for 17 holes, and that is just running the table.
This is a birdie putt to go four under.
Couldn't have an easier putt. Not too different from Tiger Woods. Not much break. Oh, got to be kidding me.
360 for Stewart, so he will remain at 300, moves to 18.
Okay, thank you, Mike and Andy. And if you just flipped over from NBC, we continue the coverage here now with Payne Stewart at the 18th hole, his second shot. Again, Payne at 3 under in a log jam at the top of the leaderboard.
Well, after hitting a pretty good drive down the left side, you can see the hole location way over here on the right-hand side. Probably be going from for the center of the green here. Didn't have much hang time, and you can see, is he going to get away with it? Is it going to stay? I don't think so.
Down it goes.
And the worst part about it is when he gets up to the top of the crest, it just got that much roller coaster ride in it. The last time he had this putt, he sort of half topped it, and it hopped up over with topspin. We'll see if he does it again. See it hopping there? But you can see it's that's about what happens when you're in that particular spot. It'll drive it right into the hill. That's why I think it's better to hit a 3-wood from there, because it gets it going up a little bit. But watch this here. He'll drive it right into the straight into the hill. And of course it doesn't want to roll. It's hitting into a bank. So off it hops and absorbs energy, and you end up coming up short.
So many little nuances to these greens that sometimes the television angle doesn't justify. But that was a good description of what these guys are faced with.
I think it's a very important putt to keep them smiling.
The lone blemish at 18 for Payne Stewart.
And that is not a happy Payne Stewart there. Lost two shots the last two holes. And even though 68, he'd have taken it before he teed off. Right now, he's got a little bit of a slow burn.
We are live. Dan Hicks here at the Pinehurst Resort and Country Club at story number two. Much different day of golf for the competitors today as the breezes have kicked up here in North Carolina. Winds out of the northeast at 15 to 20 miles an hour. No rain in the forecast, but Tiger Woods and others found out that the conditions have changed indeed today. 2 under round of 68 yesterday. Tiger was +2 on his round today as he came to the par 3 ninth and got one back. Birdie for Tiger there, added another one at the par 5 10th to get back to 2 under for the championship. Payne Stewart, two early birdies today. This one at the 7th got him to 4 under, and he had sole possession of the lead for a moment. But he bogeyed the 8th. And then here at the par 3 ninth, 185 yards, Payne Stewart got another taste of what the Donald Ross greens can do. Rear left hole location, a long way away from the hole, drifted back, and Payne with bogey 2 in a row, dropped back to 2 under. Story of the first round, John Daly. Parred his first 5 holes today after the opening round of 68, but that string was over when he missed that par putt at the 6th to drop back to 1 under. He also bogeyed the 7th, so he's back to even par for the championship, +2 on his round today. Tim Herron got off to a great start today. Birdied the first hole, and then here at the 2nd, birdied that one as well. Herron, who finished tied for 2nd last week in Memphis, climbs up the leaderboard, but he just bogeyed the difficult 5th hole, and he falls out of a tie for the lead. So David Duvall, the number one player in the world, yet to tee off. He'll tee off with Mickelson in less than an hour. Mickelson also with a 67 yesterday, as did Billy Mayfair and Paul Goitis. But you see Woods lurking there at 2-under, Payne Stewart at 2-under, and Tim Herron at 2-under. So the second round underway from Story, Pinehurst number 2. And there is Payne Stewart for par at the 12th. Clutch putt for Payne Stewart. So after those back-to-back bogeys at 8 and 9, Stewart has righted the ship. Three straight pars to begin his back nine. He par 4, 383 yards, dogleg right, back up the hill. Payne Stewart.
Most of the players here go with a fairway wood off this tee. Just need to get the ball in the fairway and in position. That should be perfect for a short iron second back up the hill.
To 13, second shot for Payne Stewart. Andy North with this group.
126 yards, wind helping from right to left. Hole's located just over the left front bunker. Just as you'd expect, try to throw it past the hole, take the bunker out of play. Well done.
Payne Stewart has a birdie attempt to get back to 3-under and a share of the lead.
13 is very quick from back to front. This ball all should break for his right. Just set it out and let the slope take it.
Only 7 players under par on their rounds today. Payne Stewart for par 13.
Some of these short putts are going to get a lot quicker. I would suspect the green speeds will pick up about a foot on the stimp meter today. Got to be very careful in these little downhillers. Well, hold.
So Payne's got a streak of 4 straight pars on the back nine after the back-to-back bogeys on the front dropped him from 4-under to 2-under. 14, second shot on the way for Payne Stewart.
Payne had 182 yards, playing back into the breeze. This ball's going to come up to the right. That'll be a very difficult up and in.
Payne Stewart.
Stewart's in the first cut with a little bit of a downslope, but he does have some green. If he just can lob it onto the green, he's got about 15 feet to play with. He does not want to go long, obviously.
Always a wonderful pitcher of the ball.
Great hands, Roger.
Great hands, and that's a good leave underneath the hole.
Roger, I just get the feeling as these conditions get more difficult that Payne Stewart just kind of goes along about his business, just has the great hands, as you mentioned, and as it gets so much more difficult around these greens, you got to figure he might be in the hunt again. Payne for par at 14, Andy.
Stewart just doesn't get flustered. He's got the mentality to win U.S. Opens. You know, he loves chipping and putting and holding these type of putts.
You're right, Andy. I mean, he has just gotten better and better at the open demeanor, if you will. He just seems to just lock in. Stewart remains one back of Duvall and Mickelson. Again, they have yet to tee off. They will play in the same group. Par 4, 7th. Herron, birdie try.
Putt should swing from right to left.
And that is birdie number 3 for Herron. 2-under on his round today. Back a hole, tee at 15, Payne Stewart. 2-under and working on a string of pars on the back nine, 5 straight.
Syrupy tempo as always. Beautifully played shot, green's still receptive. That's changing.
Bob Rotella as well, and now at 15, birdie opportunity for Payne Stewart. This for a share of the lead. Payne Stewart, one of the more steady rounds today, picks up his 3rd birdie of the day, moves to 1-under on his round today.
Well, it was this championship last year that really rekindled Payne Stewart's interest in the game, showing him he could still do it, and it's really turned his play around in the last year.
Beach, Florida, David Duvall.
Again, the number one player in the world.
Duvall's only poor shot yesterday was the tee shot on number 1.
Four victories already. which has spurred talk about Duvall as the next dominant player on the PGA Tour for years to come. He's only 27.
The wind's got this, is headed a bit right. That's fine.
Just in the intermediate cut of rough.
Carlos Franco.
And Carlos Franco, don't forget about him. Opening round of 69 yesterday. A great story out of Paraguay, who won earlier this year at New Orleans after finishing tied for sixth at the Masters.
Dan Losman said about Carlos and how poorly he putts at times. Yesterday, 23 putts, the lowest in the championship. 9 on the back 9. Mm.
From Scottsdale, Arizona, Phil Mickelson.
Still in search of the major championship. It was Mickelson who tied Franco, tied for sixth at the Masters, and this is the longest he has gone in a season without a victory.
Going with the fairway wood here.
Perfect.
16, co-leader Payne Stewart.
They seem to like it. That will catch the primary rough on the left-hand side. Looks to have settled down a little bit. They get the dirt.
Payne Stewart forced to pitch out from the rough, so this will be his third at the par 4 16th.
Needs to be aggressive and get this ball back to the hole. Yeah, that's a good one. Very good shot.
Chance to save par for Stewart. Back at 16, this is a par attempt for Payne Stewart after he drove it in the rough on this hole.
It's back downhill slightly. This would be a great save of par. Yeah. Always in the middle. Great four.
Vintage Open saving par and a vintage Payne Stewart saving par. Pitched out, took his medicine, still made his par four at the long 16th.
In front of him isn't too severe, he will putt it. If he feels like he has to hit it too hard and the slope is severe, he'll take out his three wood, get the ball up on top of the Bermuda and run it up the hill.
Yeah, we just saw Justin Leonard make bogey from a similar position. It's certainly a rare mistake for Justin. I would expect Tiger would get this up and down. Beautiful speed.
When I was in the practice round with him Wednesday, that's all he practiced on every hole was putting from off the edges of the greens. It's really paying off.
Easy tap in par for Tiger Woods. He follows up the 68 with a 71, one under for the championship. Payne Stewart is at the tee at 17, three under. Gallery murmuring about this shot.
Beautiful birdie opportunity.
Payne Stewart is at 17 and does have this for birdie, sole possession of the lead.
This putt, a little bit of a double breaker, tries to move a little left, but it, in the area of the hole, seems to straighten up, might even go back a shade right. Saw the right part, but it just didn't do much at all.
To the tee at 18, Payne Stewart.
Turn on. Forces Paul to turn left. Looked like he got up ahead of it a little bit.
Looks like he got a decent kick. Payne Stewart, his second from that rough.
If he's going to miss, wants to leave it short. The difficulty is, if he lands short, it's not going to get up onto the green. If he lands it on top of the crown up by the hole, it may get well through the green or to the back part anyway. He's going to be faced with a very lengthy putt. Not a bad play, though.
This is the fourth time in the last 10 years playing a big part in these championships. Payne Stewart has become a fixture in the Open and is doing it again this year. This for birdie and a share of the lead.
This putt through the swale on this green and back uphill. Should move a little bit to his right. And that's not what he was looking for. Put himself a good five and a half feet.
Again, the length of putt you have to make in these championships, many of them through the course of the four rounds. Is to stay within one.
Just sneaks in, but he'll take it.
He had a few of those in the back nine, Roger, to save par. A 69 for Payne Stewart after the 68 yesterday. And that is a fine score on this difficult Friday.
And actually, I'd say that 69 is probably a better score in relation to how the course is playing than yesterday's 68.
Well, Payne Stewart joins us now, and here we are again, Payne, in the hunt. In an open, you're within two strokes of the lead going to the weekend for the fifth time in 9 years. And after what happened last year, I mean, that's pretty gutsy effort.
Well, thank you very much. It's, I don't know, I guess the U.S. Open just brings it out of me.
Well, Payne, I know I talked to you at the Memorial Tournament, and I know you always get up for the Open. I know how special it is to you. But I think you sense that Pinehurst number two is a particularly good golf course for Payne Stewart's talents.
Roger, I like it. It allows you to do a lot of things. And, you know, just for instance, like on the last hole, I've got 161 to the front and 170, and I've got a jumping line. I know I hit 8-iron. I knew I could get it there. And, I didn't hit a very good first putt, but I went ahead and knocked the next one in. But, you know, it's a type of U.S. Open that we haven't had in the past, where you can actually, you know, catch a lie in the rough and play the game that that we have to play out here, especially at Pinehurst. And, you know, that's what they want us to do, is jump right into the thinking we can put it on the green out of the rough, and then all the fun begins.
Well, you did have a little bit of fun on the front nine today, Payne. You got a birdie at the fourth, got to 3-under, and then this birdie at seven got you sole possession of the lead at 4-under.
Well, I hit a 3-iron and 9-iron in there about, 12 feet, and ended up knocking it in the hole. And then I put a real good swing on a
tee shot at 9.
Well, it was a good swing. It was just the wrong club. But, you know, the wind, I tell you what, it's testy out there today.
A couple of bogeys back-to-back, dropped to 2-under, and then this birdie at 15, though.
That's a pair of twos there on that hole. I like to keep playing that hole.
And you played great open golf here. You took your medicine. You pitched out after driving in the rough and gave yourself a chance to save par here at 16.
Well, in the past, you know, I'd probably tried to force a 6-iron or something over that bunker that you really can't see in the rough. And I just think I'm smarter now. And I played an 8-iron out there. I went ahead and took my medicine and hit a nice wedge shot. My wedge game's been pretty solid. And I just wanted to give myself a chance to make a par, and hit a good wedge shot and made the putt.
Well, Payne, as this golf course continues to firm up and the greens effectively become smaller and smaller and smaller, the short game becomes even more valuable. Don't you think that kind of plays into your game and your short game abilities coming into the weekend?
Well, Roger, if you looked at my statistics on tour, I miss a lot of greens, so I have to do something pretty well.
Well, Payne, we still have a lot of golf left, but with the way the golf course has toughened up you could be leading at the day's end. I'm sure you've thought about that a little
bit. Well, you know, whether I'm leading or not, we're still going to have to play 36 more holes, and we're not going to have a rain out here. So whether I am or whether I'm not, it's irrelevant. I've got 36 holes to play, and I've got to put it on the green more often than I did today.
This is not a very good lie for Tiger Woods in the left rough.
Bad angle, too.
He missed this fairway yesterday, though.
Got to hit it out to the right, I would think.
Oh, anything to the right of that would have been okay.
It stayed up, but that's no bargain, I can tell you that. And you can see Tiger Woods here aiming away from this hole location over in this area here. Very tough lie. And that right there, folks, was a half shank right on the hosel. And you talk about a way to open up your eyes to U.S. Open pressure in the third round. That is not the way to get the round underway. Look at this. Watch this. He opens the face, coming into it, and just flat skull shanked it.
Now live, his fourth shot.
It's got to get up, doesn't it?
It sure does. He's going to have a good 12, 15 feet.
Let's go to number one.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the 2:55 starting time from Ponte Vedra Beach, Florida, David Duval.
I really believe the conditions are such that he can spread himself from the field with his talent today. This is a perfect day for him to just take this championship and say it's mine. But he needs a good start, not like Tiger. Going with the driver. Appears to be the way you start a third round of the United States Open when you're tied for the lead. That gives himself a birdie opportunity in this tough left hole location.
And from Orlando, Florida, Payne Stewart.
Stewart, a sentimental choice, so close last year. 36-hole leader in the Open for the fourth time in 9 years. Only Alex Smith and Arnold Palmer have led more times at the halfway mark with five.
Almost averaging 30 yards short of David Duval off the tee, just a 253-yard average. Appears to be going with something just to get it in the fairway. Three wood. Good shots. Good start. Just moves a little right at the hole.
Never had a chance, Johnny.
It's the first double bogey he's had in the championship.
Well, when you hit two wedges, a three wood and a driver all in the same hole, a lot of times that will add up to a double.
That's too bad.
And earlier, Phil Mickelson, his third shot.
Not a bad spot to be, really isn't. Not bad at all. And he proves that by almost knocking it in the hole, and a good start.
Neil, that wind gust forcing him to reset.
And if nothing else, he has a lot of wisdom, more than probably the whole leaderboard, first page of the leaderboard combined, as far as his past experience.
The shot starts at the right side of the green, not drawing much, just slightly.
You think that isn't a smart shot, Rod?
Well, that was a nice accompaniment. The chimes from the village church, the village chapel, and a little golfing music from Payne Stewart. Man that can make some big putts.
That was an amazing championship last year. Really was. They couldn't have drawn it up any more interesting.
Number three putter on tour this year.
Not a lot of break. It looks good. Oh, that was a good roll. Nice stroke.
I think the player has to leave alone. Got to get the ball up into the center of the green. Maybe 15, 20, 25 feet left of the hole.
Well, and even short of the hole here, Roger, we've seen some balls come in a pin high that far left of the hole and end up rolling off the back left portion of the green. So,
Gary, the only way you can hit this green, don't you think, is to hit a pretty good fade?
Well, I would say from this angle, yes. And it looks as though he's aiming well left, Johnny.
And he's got to shape that thing over this way. Otherwise, it's going to run through the green.
This ball has started the left side of the green, cutting slightly. Wind stood that ball up, John.
Back at the second, Payne Stewart's pitch from in front of the green using his sand wedge. And playing it nicely, carrying it up onto the top part of the green, letting it roll out. Shorter putt for a par.
And this length of putt, Payne has handled very well this week. It's just over 4 feet, not much break at all.
Stewart, who misses the shorter putt and drops back to 2 under par for the championship.
To the third.
And Payne Stewart.
122 yards to the hole. Hole tucked in the front left portion of the screen. Players just have to keep the ball right of the hole here. Anything short or left is a bad miss. It's a pitching wedge. The shot going right at it. Looks good.
Is good. That was a gorgeous golf swing, Roger.
Pretty syrupy.
A birdie opportunity to move back into a share for the lead. Payne, who's 42, and the other young Lions, Mickelson 29, DeVol 27, Tiger 23, trying to hold off the next generation and win his second U.S. Open championship.
Boy, what a swing.
Off the fourth tee, Payne Stewart, that classic right swing.
Right down the middle of the fairway. We'll try to put this ball in position. Best position, left center of the fairway.
Left is a good spot because of the hole location on the right side. Gives himself a little bit more green to work with. And position B for Payne. Just a little 60-yard pitch shot here for Payne Stewart at this par 5 fourth. Looking for a little spin. Gets a little. Stewart will have that coming back for birdie.
To four.
Birdie putt on the way for Stewart. This is such a feel putt. Just didn't give it quite enough speed, but if you pop it a little bit too firm, it can get racing back down the hill. So a par 5 for Payne remains at 3 under. 29 players were under par for the first round. There are just 4 under par right now.
Payne Stewart with a driver.
Perfect shot. As we said, it's right down there. Excuse me.
This tee shot going down the left center of the fairway. That should be good. Cut a little bit. That's perfect. Well, wind at his back slightly. Payne has a 6-iron from 197 yards. I'm sure just trying to put it right of the hole up in the middle of the green if he can. Just going at the right side of the green.
Needs to hit softly. Oh, it does. And that is a well-played shot. That is right where you want to be aiming.
Let's go to 5.
And the trials and tribulations of David Duvall. This is
elected to play away from the hole, which I thought was a wise play, but the ball jumps out of the rough and he'll miss on the other side.
That's not the first time we've seen that today, Roger, from that left side. Fourth shot, David Duvall. Well played, but still a lot of work left for a bogey 5. Pretty putt at the 5th. Back up the hill at the end and turning left, and that's got to get going.
Well, that's understandable, Gary. You missed that putt much longer, much right. You could put it right off the green.
This is par to stay at plus 1.
That's Duvall's bogey putt. That looked like it was pulled. So David Duvall with a double bogey at the hardest hole on the course. We will now drop back to even par for the championship. Up ahead at the seventh, Vijay Singh did manage to make his par.
There's a man who is not struggling.
Payne Stewart safely in for a par at the fifth. And he remains in the lead at 3 under.
Plenty of club, Roger, for him. Long hitting iron player. Hole location back left. Par is a great score.
Starts his ball at the center of the green.
I thought that was a lot of club for him as far as he hits his irons, and it was too much. And again, he knows better than to go long.
Let's go to the leader, Payne Stewart.
Well, Payne through the green, pitching back from about 50 feet, is elected to use the sand wedge, bump it into the slope to kill its momentum.
Not bad at all. A wise play, much right of the hole, could go right off the green.
Not much break.
Dead center. Stewart remains at 3 under in the lead.
Is he losing it right?
He's lost it right.
He came off of that one. And that could be not a good spot because that got well up into the bunker.
Rats.
And that's a rats, as he says.
Difficult second shot for Phil Mickelson. But again here, Mark, it sets up for his draw. Back right hole location.
Danny had 208 yards, and it was really as well played as it could have been.
Beautiful shot. A chance for a rare birdie at 8. And again, look at the back of this green. Showed it earlier in the telecast. Long and left. Just about dead. To 7.
Payne Stewart in the bunker.
And I thought it took a big hop up into the face, and it did. And any shot here, Raj, can you get it there?
He's got 161 yards to the hole, John. The good news is it's downwind. Mike could get it to the front, but I'd be surprised if he could get much more than that out of it.
Looks like an 8 iron, a nuke gate, huh?
Got to get it up very quickly.
Going left.
He's done that. It is going just left of the hole.
Wow. You got to be kidding me.
Well, I'll tell you what, the downwind really helped that shot there, John. That is brilliant.
That was a phenomenal shot. And he knows it. But he's being very cool, Roger.
And as the rain falls, Tiger Woods, or Payne Stewart, who leads Tiger Woods by 4 with a birdie chance.
They hit it. A little bit of rain might have been the difference right there. It'll slow it down.
Stewart taps in for his par to remain 3 under for the championship, and his lead is still 1 over Phil Mickelson.
Now Mickelson. As the players leave this short.
Oh,
not Mickelson.
What a birdie.
Just the 5th today at the 8th. Again, the most difficult hole today in the championship, and Mickelson has caught Payne Stewart. And you can sense it from the gallery. A lot of people pulling for Phil. Back on the tee, Stewart right behind him. Again, a long par 4.
He obviously heard that roar, but he's driven the ball right down the center of the fairway. Backed away, has 211 to the hole, uphill, side hill lie, ball above his feet. That's a 4 iron.
Again, back right hole location.
Going right.
Oh. So I could found the bunker, and it did.
Well, he hit it right with a long iron in the last hole and got away with it, and another one here.
Third shot, Payne Stewart, this difficult 8.
Shot. That's beautiful there, from about 100 feet.
Pushed it.
Not by much. Stewart will drop a shot. All back to 2 under. So now Phil Mickelson has
sole possession of the lead again.
At the ninth, Payne Stewart's tee shot.
It's the six iron and pulled left, Gary. Watch out, Gowrie.
Ooh. That's where Vijay Singh's ball ended up earlier, and that's not good.
23 players were under par after the first round. False sense of security. Then seven players in red figures after 36 holes, and now there are only two.
To nine.
And the little pitch shot for Payne Stewart. Off the bare dirt where the gallery had been walking, and Johnny, that is nicely executed.
He's together. He bogeyed the last hole, but he has played well within himself. Missed a little putt at number two, but I like his game right now.
At the ninth, Payne Stewart for his par, putt that moves a little left. Back-to-back bogeys for Stewart. And eight and nine. Drops to one under for the championship. That was not his best stroke.
With the tee at the par 5 10th. Payne Stewart after bogey. And
okay,
gets a good bounce.
Yeah, good shot.
Payne Stewart well over 300 yards from the hole. His second shot here at 10. Missed a layup. He's got this ball headed at that left fairway bunker. I believe it may catch it.
Hit it right into the neck there, Roger. It's only 25 yards wide where he tried to sneak it through.
Stewart's third shot at this par 5.
Got the ball above his feet and trying to hit a straight or a little fade off a hook lie and paid the price for a poor layup. Man, that was not a good shot at all.
Sour run for Stewart. Bogey at 8, bogey at 9, and treble at 10.
Well, fourth shot of Payne Stewart in this par 5, but these players are on the clock. They are being timed for being out of position. And a shot of Payne's now.
This is as tough as it looks.
Yeah, it runs away, John. I mean, this is a very difficult shot to land up on the green and get it to stop. That needs to get down or check up. Oh, it does.
At 10, Payne Stewart.
David Duval has already putted past the hole some three and a half feet. Payne Stewart now with a downhill putt. Not a lot of break in it, but has missed two putts of this length or shorter already. That was pulled. That was left all the way.
Three straight bogeys for Stewart. Even for the championship. And Phil Mickelson, the only player in red numbers at the moment, leads by 3. From the bunker, the third shot, Payne Stewart.
Well, Payne flew his second shot into this hole just about a yard long past the flagstick and first bounce back in the back bunker. That's a shot of about 30-35 feet. It's starting to drizzle again slightly.
So that'll be a test for his par after bogeying each of the last three holes.
Now,
Payne Stewart at 11, that's for par. Finally stops the bogey train that had taken him from minus 3 to even. He remains just 2 from Mickelson.
Payne Stewart ready for his second, Roger.
201 to the hole from the center of the fairway. This is a 4-iron. And just another hole location. It looks like the players have to play away from. It just looks so hard to try to get the ball close here. Needs to be right of the hole in the center of the green.
And it has to land short of the center of the green, Roger.
It's a pretty good looking shot at the center of the green, but the wind catches that a bit. It'll catch the very front.
Not bad. Short is good at 12. Let's take a look at Payne's scorecard. At the second, birdie at the third, a couple of bogeys to end the front nine, and another one at the 10th.
Back to 12.
Long birdie attempt by Payne Stewart.
He should move from right to left all the way.
Gather a little speed, but not that much. Back to the 12th, another one of those open par savers, Payne Stewart.
So solid on him. Remains even. Just two back.
This is a sand iron back up the hill, but what a tough hole location this.
But you got a little bit of backboards if you can, you know, spin it. Isn't that right, Dan?
Yep. Well, we've seen a lot of players do that. Also, if you come up short, it can be a big problem. So there's a certain amount of risk to that.
Plenty of room left to the hole.
Man. Shot's not that tough.
Well, after the rather conservative play to the left of the hole, Payne Stewart lining up his birdie attempt, Raj.
Well, that's about 35 feet downhill. We'll move to his right.
Well, nothing wrong with a par.
Only been able to play the shots, the real tough ones like that one at 15, Gary. And that was a fabulous shot with the putter.
We get word that's a six iron, and that he would have to really hammer.
Well, he has hit it right, and this is not going to be good, Gary.
Well, he finds the bunker. Not much green to work with and a lot of slope.
He's overhooked a bunch of shots, hasn't he?
Yeah, guys. He certainly has, releasing the club very early. We go to 14.
And an opening, perhaps, for this man, Stewart, his approach.
That's an 8-iron from 161, but pulled well left. Catches the front left corner, though.
But none of the players at the moment able to seize any opportunity.
Back at 15, Tiger Woods now on the tee. He's hit just 7 of 14 greens so far today. A 5-iron appeared to be trying to play a little cut shot, Mark.
It's right at it, Gary.
Oh, it is. Oh, the best shot of the day at 15 by Tiger Woods. So Tiger Woods with a golden opportunity to pick up a stroke at the 15th. Phil Mickelson holding a 2-shot lead at the moment, but he's in the bunker. We'll be right back to see what happens. While he waits, we'll go to 14.
Long birdie chance for Payne Stewart. Started the day at -3, he's now even.
It's about a 40 footer, a little bit of a double breaker, left to right at the start, and then may go back left at the end.
Roger, since that little bit of rain, we haven't hardly seen a putt get to the hole, long putt.
This is certainly no tap in, but he's been very good from this distance today. He's not missed one yet.
A little too much speed there.
Boy, he did have a little explosion with that one.
Well, a chance for a 2-stroke swing now. Here we are, that lot of speed.
That had gone in with the right speed for sure.
So Mickelson for a bogey 4.
Old man par is looking better by the minute, isn't it, Gary?
Well, John, it just seems to always be the case in a U.S. Open championship, doesn't it? All right. Mickelson drops to 1-under for the championship.
Chance for a 2-shot swing for Tiger.
Back at 14.
Payne Stewart's par putt to remain even. And that slides him up the ladder to within one.
Back at the 15th. Tiger Woods now with a chance for a birdie. To move within 2 of the lead.
Boy, what a 2 this would be, Gary, at this stage of the championship. It's still only the 3rd round, but big momentum builder if he could get this one in.
There have just been 3 birdies here all day.
You got to give him a lot of credit, don't you, Gary? And Mark, he starts out, 3 over after 2 holes today. Anything could have happened, and since then he just played level, and now this gives him a chance to be 1-under since the 2nd hole.
Good stroke, good 2.
Tiger Woods moves to one over for the championship and within two of the lead.
Go back to 15.
Five iron from Payne Stewart. Just pulled going at the left side of the green, not cutting, will miss left.
And he'll be faced with another one of those decisions, which club to play. Back to the par 3 15th, and Payne Stewart preparing for his second shot. Roger.
Well, this from 45 or 50 feet. A gentle upslope here leading the green. Payne selected a putter, should move a little bit from his left to right.
Well judged, but leaves him another one of those very difficult putts for par. That same 4, 5, 6 foot range. Back at the 16th, second shot for Phil Mickelson.
214 yards, ball just stayed in the fairway.
Could be a little problem with that edge again. So.
Go. Go. This ball's kind of ballooning.
Yeah, back into the breeze a little bit. That comes up a good 5 yards short of the putting surface. You can see a little bit of rain starting to fall again. Back at the 15th, par putt for Payne Stewart. Made it even for the championship. All right, safely in. Stewart with another good par save. Well, John, the players have been missing this putt to the right most of the time. Ball just kind of eking its way ever so slightly in that direction. Just like that. Well, now we have no one under par for the championship.
I tell you what, Tiger Woods is like seeing raw meat.
And Payne Stewart preparing for his second shot. Roger.
245 yards left to the hole.
Vijay Singh did make his bogey putt up at 17 to drop to two over for the championship.
This is a two iron. I assume he's trying to chase this ball in. That's a long way to hit a two iron. He's hit it low and very solid.
Oh, what a nice shot.
What a great shot that is. That was drilled, Gary.
Well, had to carry the ball some 220 yards just to get it to the front edge of the green. So beautifully done.
The 17th tee, Phil Mickelson.
And this sets up perfectly for his draw. You can throw it right there, start it right there, and draw it right into the heart of the green. You're watching it, Phil.
This one's long also.
Oh, man, these guys are super cooked.
So both Woods and Mickelson in the back bunker. What a third round.
Of him.
Yeah, he needs to carry it pretty far up onto the green.
That's what I thought.
Well, he did just that. It checked up a little sooner than he thought.
Well, he's got that super lofted lob wedge, and he can hit it harder than anybody else. And of course, when you hit it harder, it spins more and allows him to play a lot of shots differently than anyone in the field.
This hole, they'll play like match play. Woods and Mickelson with similar distance putts. Now Stewart.
Birdie attempt at 16. This putt slow, back up the hill slightly. And that not a very good effort. At the 16th, par putt now for Payne Stewart to remain even for the championship, tied for the lead. Okay. Take a sigh there, Payne. Yeah, okay, you can breathe again.
Back-to-back bogeys at 15 and 16.
He needs this putt.
And Johnny, I think what Tiger Woods has done the last three holes has really had an impact on Phil. I hate to say it, but Tiger has got the crowd energized toward him. It's just a completely different feeling now.
Mickelson's third straight bogey sends Payne Stewart into the top spot alone with Woods, Mickelson, and Heron one back. Duvall, Singh, Stricker with a 69 today, within two of the lead.
This is a six iron. Ball starts at the center of the green, is cutting right at the flag stick.
Oh, that's a little unlucky. That took a big hop, trickling. Not bad, though. Good shot. Should go a little right at the hole. Good putt, huh, Roger?
Good putt from there. He'll take that.
Knows this is a tough hole location for his draw. Does not match at all. In fact, he should just forget about trying to get it closer and just get it on the front right, front middle right, and get out of here with maybe a 30-foot putt. Maybe he'll make it.
It's right at the flag, but should be just a little short. Took a big bounce, so
perfect shot.
Wow.
Look at that luck.
That's what Amy's been waiting for.
And saluting both those men as they come up 18, and Payne Stewart secures his par at 17. He still has a grip on the lead at even par.
Just put myself after three rounds with a chance to win the championship, and that's just what he's done for basically a mulligan from last year. He really had last year's championship in hand. The divot that he went into really killed him on number 13, but number 12, and that really hurt him there. Still got to keep hitting those fairways. See that pretty camera angle shot, ball rising up right down the right center.
Not nearly as long as Duvall, but he's safely in the fairway. And we go up to the green at 18, Tiger Woods. Yeah, the last time those chimes sounded, it's 6:30 here in North Carolina. Who was it? Somebody played some nice music.
Somebody made
it. It was
birdie.
Mickelson, wasn't it?
That's right.
Maybe yeah. It's Woods' turn to sing.
Well, this putt here is sort of up the fall line. It's really, you can't be a much better position. It goes straight all the way until the last foot, and then it just tries to go a little right. Did he hit it? Oh, well, still a good finish. I really believe one of the reasons why the guys did better the last hour or so is that the wind, like we talked about, just died out this afternoon, and that made a big difference, because of these crown greens, turtleback greens, when you factor in wind, forget it.
Well, it wasn't quite as the chimes rang out, glory, glory, hallelujah, but he's praising the fact he's close.
First chance he's had it, really winning the United States Open. He's right there, it's within his reach.
And this would be huge for Phil at this stage. Having gone through that stretch of bogeys, hit a terrific shot in. Put him in a great frame of mind going into tomorrow.
Just got a little bit of break here. Standing ovation.
What an up and down round for Mickelson. He had the lead by a couple of strokes at the turn. Let it slip away with four bogeys in the backside, three in a row, 15, 16, and 17, and yet had enough inside to call upon some great shot making and birdie 18, and leaves with a 73. Tied for first. After each of the three rounds of this championship, will he remain tied? That's up to this man, Payne Stewart.
Raj, was that roar as loud as I think it was?
It was indeed. You could see the grandstands all stand up when that putt went in. 60. Flag now hanging limp, John. As you said, the wind has died out. It's not much of a factor at all.
It's the guys have played early, and we had really no great rounds early. really had tough conditions all 18 holes, and these guys had tough for what, 12 holes anyway?
Well, that's right. There were some great rounds earlier. They just weren't very low scores.
It's all relative.
Great for what the conditions were at the time.
What's he going to hit here? It's 264-yard drive.
182 yards left of the hole, John. He's got a 6-iron. What breeze there is helping the players a little bit from the right and just trying to hit this ball from the center of the green, see if he can get it to get up back to the hole. And he's backed off, John. I think he's done a real good job today of regrouping after that stretch at 8, 9, and 10. You know, everybody has those in the U.S. Open, and if you lose your patience, then it continues to go the wrong way. But he's hung in there, continue to be very patient, has holed a couple of nice putts to save par, and he's really done a good job of gathering himself.
A little self-talk there, talking to himself. Come on, Payne. One more good iron. Very smooth swing. How is it?
Best shot's going at it, John.
Boy, he's hit some beautiful irons coming in. The shot at 16 was darn near reminiscent of Ben Hogan at Marion. It was such a beautiful 2-iron, carried 220 yards. Good shot at 17, another good one at 18. Roger just moves a little right.
It should as it loses speed, John.
Well, it's a green light putt uphill. I don't have to worry about two putting. So he's looking left edge.
What a climax to a great day of golf here at Pinehurst. As he did last year, Payne Stewart will start the final round as the leader for the U.S. Open Championship.
Well, that was a hard-fought round, and that's what he's saying. Now, Roger, you talk about a round that'll wear you out or cause a few gray hairs around the temple.
They're going to want to sleep tonight. I'll promise you, this golf course, certainly for the first 3 hours they were on it, was everything and more than they'd want to handle.
Well, 72 is one heck of a score.
Now Duvall for his par. Him just three shots from the lead.
Well, Payne, you know, that's a heck of a good finish right there. The last three iron shots, I was saying the shot at 16 looked like Ben Hogan and Marion with his 1-iron. Yours was the 2-iron. Was you carried that ball 220 yards and then hit a super shot at 17 and then 18, painted it right in there, right where you wanted to. So you got to feel really good about that.
Well, Johnny, I do like the way I finished. And you know, the birdies, you know, you watched it all today. You know how few birdies there were out there to be had. And, you know, I finally had the pace right on a putt that was of a makeable distance on 18, and fortunately it went in.
72 is really not too over par, right?
I think that's even par today.
It might be about 3 under. But.
Well, Payne, you've said all along since last year's disappointment at Olympic, you just wanted another serious chance again this year. You've got it.
Yes, I do. And, you know, I'm looking forward to tomorrow. I wanted this opportunity, and now I got to go out and deal with it.
Well, good luck tomorrow, and we won't ask you what's on the supper menu tonight. I know you've been cooking and kicking. Maybe they're kicking and you're cooking here in Pinehurst, North Carolina. Looking forward to your round tomorrow.
Thank you very much.
Payne Stewart.
He's got 146 to the hole, wind in his face.
Looks like he's taking dead aim right at it, not aiming left.
That's it, Tiger.
Wow. Wow. How about that shot? What a strike of the one he had yesterday.
Double bogey yesterday at one and a chance for birdie start today.
That's imperative. He makes this for his confidence. It'll haunt him if he doesn't the rest of the day.
He's even par for the championship.
Look at that look. That's resolve right there.
Out of the first tee.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the final pairing. From Scottsdale, Arizona, Phil Mickelson.
Thirteen wins, no majors. Now's the time, Phil. You got the people pulling for you.
29 earlier this week.
Going with driver. I think a lot of people are having trouble seeing the ball. That's why there wasn't a big, really, applause to that shot. It's just sort of going
and
out of view.
Orlando,
very
Florida,
good shot.
Payne Stewart.
Payne Stewart, of course, got an open title under his belt, but he's got last year also that he's got to be thinking about and having to address his four-shot lead. He's taken away by Lee Jansen, so it's an important tee shot, like we said. Got the cutoff rain gear. Just what the doctor ordered.
It's important to note that the leader going into the final round of this championship has won only 42% of the times. 41 out of 98 championships. The last to do it was Ernie Els at Oakmont in 94.
Payne has 156 yards to the hole. I think he's got to be looking a little underneath, and a little left of the hole would be ideal. This is a 7-iron.
We're just talking about aiming here. Solid strike, huh?
Good strike, going up the center of the green, cutting a little bit, just left of the hole.
Textbook, Roger.
Beautiful play.
Wow, that's a good sign.
This is Stewart's birdie putt.
Moves right, looks good.
The seasoned veteran Stewart.
I mean, it's just amazing to see these players. Yesterday, they struggled under pressure. It seems like they got it out of their system, and now, we're seeing really top quality golf.
And at one for his par putt.
Oh,
how pure. Mickelson, Stewart, Woods, Heron, Mayfair, Duvall. They all start well, and it's Stewart with a two-shot advantage.
Perfect shot to cut it, huh?
This one moving just right of the hole, at the right side of the green, comes up short.
And that will funnel down.
How they've been doing over there, Gary?
Well,
today?
That's a similar position to where Tim Heron was just ahead of him, and Tim played a nice shot up there and got it up and down, but it's not an easy shot.
He does have the more difficult of the two shots between he and Phil Mickelson. A little bit of a downhill slope, but he is pitching back uphill.
Stewart led the tour in the scrambling statistics in 1998, getting it up and down 66% of the time. No, I don't think so, Johnny. That's going to come right back off the green.
Wow, after a great birdie at number one, just threw that away with that shot.
He selected to go with the putter, and there's a lot of moisture in this grass right now. Very damp. That's not even close to hit hard enough. That's left himself a good 6 feet. Yeah, I believe this is a huge putt.
Well, Roger, I would tend to agree with you. After the well-played first hole, he seemed to have everything going his way, very positive. This could be a huge negative if he were to miss this.
Left edge putt.
Well stroked. So a hard-working five at the second hole for Payne Stewart. Drops him to one under par for the championship, but importantly, still one ahead of Woods, Duvall, and Mickelson.
Phil Mickelson has already missed this fairway to the right.
So once they hit about, what, 220 yards, Roger, that'll leave him about 130 yards to the middle of the green.
He's done so perfectly, John.
He's birdied three twice this week.
This is a 9-iron. Just right of the hole.
Wow.
Beautiful shot.
Back to three.
And the leader, Stewart, birdie putt.
On the way up to the green, Payne Stewart looked at his caddy, Mike Hicks, and said, I did hit this shot a little left of where I was aiming, so he pulled it in there close.
He leads by two.
Let's go to Roger Maltby.
Well, Payne Stewart has laid up perfectly here at four, has 104 yards to the hole, but as last year's final round, the 12th hole at Olympic Club, in a sand-filled divot.
Well, and that is not good.
That's last year at Olympic as he was battling for this championship. Bad luck.
Yeah, that's the 12th hole Olympic, and he blocked it in the right bunker.
Yep, that's right. He went from sand to sand, Johnny.
And this, with this hole location, Denny, as tough as it is, this does not help, does it?
Nope. Again, got to stay right. Anything left is a mistake.
He has chosen the sand there, and I'm sure aiming right at the hole, just trying to hit something hard and solid.
Sounded good.
No, it's got a little heavy. It's got to get up.
And it's headed left and in the bunker. So similar results from Olympic last year to today at Pinehurst number two.
Go back to four.
Fourth shot for Payne Stewart. Pretty good lie. Slope works in his favor. And look at this shot. Nearly hold it. Tap in par five for Payne Stewart. And he'll remain at two under.
Down the right side of the fairway. They want it to hop left.
Well, it does, and it catches the extreme right-hand side of the fairway. Stewart now with his second shot. Roger.
Has 209 yards to the hole, 194 to the front edge. And I'm assuming he's going to try to put something and land it just on the front right center of this green and let it try to eke left over toward the hole. But, boy, this is one you sure don't want to aim at. Yes, good looking shot going at the right center of the green, drawing just slightly.
Gets a good bounce forward, and that is a well executed shot.
About 20 feet, a little better than 20 feet, moving right to left all the way.
Pretty aggressive, Roger. Back at the fifth, Payne Stewart for par. This one is a little tricky. It will actually slide a little right. All right, well struck. Good par at the difficult fifth for Stewart. He remains at two under for the championship.
Probably a 4-iron for him, maybe a big five.
He's got the 4-iron, John. This ball just right of the hole.
Roger, he's playing like he wants to win this year.
He's got a look of resolve on his face, Johnny. Looks very different than the Payne Stewart we saw last year at the Olympic Club.
Yeah, I agree. So far, he looks pure.
Stewart admits he let one get away last year, and he's worked hard for this chance at redemption.
I'm very proud of myself for putting myself back in the position to have a chance to win today. After what happened last year, I didn't play well enough on Sunday. I got beat by a great round of golf in very difficult conditions. And all I wanted to give myself a chance to rectify that situation this year, and I have that today.
Well, it couldn't be said any better than he said it himself. And he's so far, he's met the challenge and maybe the little ghost that haunted him for the last year.
With Mickelson, the Payne is one under on his round. Mickelson, six straight pars. Stewart separating himself by two strokes from Mickelson.
This is a 7-iron.
wind slightly at his back. He's kept the ball left of the hole at the center of the green.
Let's see if that stops. It does, just barely.
You can't put it, I think. Yeah, there's lots of those.
This is a good green light shot for him, isn't it, with his little draw?
Well, it is, John, but the wind is down and from the right. Again, I would think left of the hole would be prudent. This is now an 8-iron. This ball just left of the hole.
Back at number 7 at Pinehurst number 2 and the leader Payne Stewart, long birdie putt.
Well, this is a little over 30 feet, back uphill slightly, then we'll start moving right probably in a range of 15 feet to the hole, then going back downhill slightly. Not an easy putt. This looks good here. Oh my goodness.
Okay. His face sure shows the concentration level and his determination. Nothing seems to be bothering him, Dick. The lip out when he went right over the hole on the bunker shot at number 4 didn't even faze him. That lip out there, he wasn't jumping around saying, oh, I got hosed or something, I got a bad break.
Did chew the gum a little harder when that ball rolled into the divot in the middle of the fairway on a good tee shot. He had a little tighter jaw, but. So he remains at minus 2. Phil Mickelson, birdie putt.
Makeable putt here. Just moves a little bit. That looks good. It's down. That old putter is working today.
So after 6 consecutive pars, Mickelson with a birdie to go 1 under, 1 away from the lead.
Back on the tee, Payne Stewart has bogeyed 8 and 9 in each of the last 2 rounds, so this has been a tough stretch for him. Daring that one down.
Payne now has 208 yards to hold ball slightly above his feet. 180 yards at the front edge. That's a 5-iron. Just trying to land it in the front third of the green.
Laying the ball way forward, Roger.
This ball a little bit left.
He had that ball set up so far forward, it was either going left or fat.
It was from a little better than 80 feet.
Probably leave it 8 feet short and a little right, I would think.
That's really very good from there. Uphill slightly. Been very solid with these today.
This to maintain his 1-shot lead. And that's a good 2-putt for Stewart. It remains intact, 1 better than Phil Mickelson.
10th.
And Vijay Singh, a birdie putt to pull even for the championship. Vijay Singh. 2 under on his round and now just 2 behind Stewart.
This is a 5-iron now. This ball starts way left. This going at the very, very, very left side of the green.
That might bury.
Appears to find one of the left bunkers.
So the question, with a 2-shot lead after 8, can Payne Stewart hold on to that lead? Now a 1-shot advantage.
and win his second U.S. Open title.
Well, he'll be tested right here, Dick. You can see how far left he is looking. Roger, he's got to play this ball well left of the hole.
Well left, and once it gets across that ridge about 30 feet from the hole, it will pick up speed. Well, it had some spin on it. That's a pretty nifty play right there.
Is that what you see, Raj?
Yes.
Looks like he's stroking it out to the right. It's a practice stroke. It did break.
Yeah. Just slightly. Very nicely done.
Saying that'll save his par to stay even.
Tee shot going down the left center.
Yeah, that's 8 fairways out of 8 tries today.
Well, Payne Stewart's left himself 107 yards to the hole. On a little bit of an upslope of a knob on the right-hand side of the fairway. Hole cut back left. Pretty good angle at it. This is sand iron. Player's got a guard from going left here, John.
Ball above his feet a little bit?
Ball above his feet slightly. Tendency would be to go left a little bit.
Hit it left at 4 on the other 5 par, remember, in the bunker. Same shot.
Just needs to get up.
That might go off the green. That was a very poor golf shot right there. And that might go in a bad lie. That's got a great chance to be, that's not too bad maybe, sitting up. But teed up, no grass behind it, which is the hardest lie I think there is. And then, of course, no grass on the toe of the club. So when it comes in, you want to grab that heel and stick and turn the club over. So this could be, and with standing that far below, it makes you even grab the heel more because it makes the club flatter. So the odds of him hitting this solidly are not real good, Roger.
Absolutely. He could miss this green left if he doesn't watch out.
And heavy. Want to get as close to it as you can.
He didn't get all of it, John.
Yeah, that heel was really going to grab there. You'd almost have to try to hit that 10, 12 feet by the hole. If you had to hit 100 of those and had the wisdom to play that shot 100 times, you'd realize that you're probably going to hit about 10 feet fat every time. Watch this. Good technique. Just that heel. Look at that grass fly out of the heel. And watch it again. Watch the heel of the club grab. And all that grass, both forward and back, explode and take off club head speed. Now, Roger.
Well, John, that a costly mistake. That's, I guess, a little miss club, or maybe hit it just a little fat, but. To miss the green here with the sand iron. Bad mistake.
After 10 holes of this final round, we have a tie for the lead. Payne Stewart succumbing at 10 with a bogey, and Mickelson with his par. They're at 1 under.
This ball just right of the flag stick.
It's going to get up. Nope.
Painful.
Missed the last 3 greens now, Roger, after striping it all day, except for number 2. Roger, how steep is this bank, and is it a problem, or just basically the same thing they've been working on all week?
Well, they've been working on this all week, but this is very steep. This is very steep angle he has to put up across. This will be slow, certainly, in the first part of this.
Ooh, shot left on him, Raj.
Coming back. That's not all bad, John. That is not all bad at all.
Nope. Leaves himself a sort of a curler. Slice putt. Is it left edge?
Well, I think it might go a shade right. I don't know that I'd want to get it out of the hole. But if he likes to hit it inside the hole, I'd also say you better hit it firmly. Yeah, good stroke there.
So on to 12 they go. Mickelson and Stewart still tied for the lead at one under par.
Singh had to swing out of the rough earlier, and you've got such a long distance coming into the green that makes it even more difficult.
This ball going right, headed to the right rough. First fairway is missed.
Meanwhile, Stewart at 12, second shot from a long way away, Roger.
Well, was forced to lay up, had 229 yards to the hole, and not a very good lie, so he's done the wise thing, just laid it down there fairway, leave himself a sand iron third.
This is the third shot now for Payne Stewart, Roger.
88 yards left to the hole, just the sand iron, just four paces right of this hole.
Away from the pin. Safe play.
Roger missed the last four greens in regulation, and he's paid the price now.
Phil Mickelson is a short putt away from sole possession of the lead.
And he's at that point, Roger, don't you think he's saying, oh my gosh, I'm leading the Open.
Stewart back to even.
And if you don't think that doesn't surge a little adrenaline into your system when you finally realize, hey, I'm leading the United States Open last day.
And there's only six holes left.
Safely in.
For the first time since the opening round, Phil Mickelson finds himself on top the leaderboard.
Payne Stewart with a 3-wood, his tee shot. See if he can make a good swing after missing the fairway at the previous hole. And that looks good. So Stewart continuing to battle. Let's go to Tiger Woods at 14.
And he is in the dead center of the fairway. He's got 136 yards. Not much wind at all right now.
Another one of those shots you should be knocking it inside 15 feet, Mark.
Kind of ironic. He's made par in the two greens he's missed and bogeyed the one he hit in the last three holes.
He's attacking this one.
Now he holds Tiger with par, bogey, bogey here at 14 in the championship.
Did he catch it solid or a little thin?
It might be just a shade thin this left of the hole. Not bad, John.
Oh, that's a good shot. Stewart coming right back after that. Bogey at 10, bogey at 12.
And he needs to start taking advantage of him, running out of holes. This putt is just inside 30 feet. It's going to break to Tiger's right.
Downhill?
Downhill a little bit. But you can't be cautious at this stage.
See, he's looking out in this area here.
There it is.
Yes. Look at that look. That's a new one.
He's within two.
It slid right and then it just hung in there. It looked like it was going to miss right.
And a very makeable putt downhill will run smoothly. Should move a little bit from right to left.
Right here and hit it to here with a little fade. pretty good.
This ball going right again.
And that's what happens. Some people have a propensity towards under pressure, pushing it. Some guys do the opposite and pull it. And there's a pattern there. And we'll see if he can overcome that.
And Payne Stewart, just off that fairway bunker, Roger.
He's got some problems. Has 164 yards to the hole. Has a side hill, uphill lie, John. Deep grass. This one could go anywhere. A club could shut down, go way left. It could shoot out right.
Yeah, it's easy to pull it from here.
He's hit it very, very high, going at the right center of the green. Really, I don't think he'll be displeased at all with that.
Move back to 14 for Payne Stewart.
His third shot.
Straightforward little pitch shot, Roger.
Well, it is. It'll come up over a slight brow in the green, John. Then it really starts to run away just slightly. I think this is a little faster going in this direction than it appears.
He's good at this.
I checked up real quickly on him in the middle on the second hop.
And trying to save par here is Payne Stewart. Maintain a share of the lead.
And this one should move just a little bit to Payne's left.
Tied for the lead at minus one.
Two great putts by Payne the last two holes. That's got to help him.
Wind coming from the right. I'm sure he'll try to hit his cut, hold it against that wind, and put it up right of the hole into the center of the green if he can. This ball started at the left side of the green, and the wind will not let it come right. This is going to miss left.
Welcome back. We're at the par 3 15th, and Payne Stewart preparing to play his second shot. Roger.
Well, he's got a little bit of a problem with the sprinkler head ahead of him, about 15 feet just off the putting surface. He's going to try to play a bump and run into the hill, but he's got to play close to the sprinkler head. Hit that much too hard. Hit that a little harder than you want to.
The 16th, Tiger Woods, second shot from 210. Should be a 4-iron for Tiger. He made a good pass at that. Players have been hitting this green less than 5% of the time, but not Tiger Woods. Beautiful shot within 12 feet of the flag.
How they've been doing on this, Gary?
Well, a tendency perhaps to overread the break slightly and hang the ball out on the right hand side.
He's made two great putts in a row last two holes.
Just like that. That has been the tendency. It just looks like it'll break a little more.
That was a good looking stroke.
That was a very good putt. Look, it just gets by the hole. It just refuses to turn. And he cannot believe it. So, Phil Mickelson with a short putt now and a chance to retake the lead.
This is no gimme.
Nope, not in this situation. Mickelson safely in with his par at 15. Takes a one shot lead to the difficult par 4 16th. Stewart, bogey, drops back to even.
Amazing how quiet 40,000 people can be.
This for just the third birdie of the day here at 16. Yes!
Tiger Woods to even par, just one back. And Johnny, you said he needed to play the last three and one under. Well, there's one right there.
That is huge.
And that is the hardest of the three holes.
You made that call earlier, Johnny, and I agree with you. He started to catch his stride about midway through the round. Now Payne Stewart needs to get this ball in the fairway. This tee shot going down the left-hand side as well. That should be a good tee shot as well. It is.
Oh, it is.
Good long one.
Sneaks it just past Mickelson. Short and right, and I don't know if it actually got up into the bunker or whether it caught up in the long Bermuda rough just short of it.
From my vantage, Gary, it looks as though it is caught up in the grass above the bunker.
And there it is, and it has nestled well down.
That looks like thick stuff there.
Yes, it does. So perhaps an opening for Payne Stewart. Roger his yardage.
223. Played a wonderful two iron into this green yesterday. With two iron again today. This shot low and left.
Well, it gets
a pretty
great
good hop.
Bounce. Yes, it is about 8 or 10 yards short of the putting surface, but very
came out
good
of it
position.
Huh?
Yeah, he
that
sure
was
did.
Miss hit.
I don't want you people to believe he has to make this. I mean, it would be nice. It'd be a bonus. And obviously, first things first is to make three, and if he wants to fall in, that's good too. But he's in a good position right now with both players, Stewart and Mickelson, in trouble on 16. He pars this hole, birdies the next one. Who knows what's going to happen? All above his feet, as you can see. It's easy to leave it short from here. He was going for it. You were right, Mark.
Payne is a wonderful player at these shots. One of the best I've ever seen. Day in and day out, great hands player. Usually makes terrific contact and judges distance beautifully.
But he did scoop two of these on two, and remember on 14 where he came up well short.
Better check.
Awfully firm.
What was that, Roger?
I think he got at that a little harder than he wanted to. I don't know if you want to call that the open pressure or whatever, but he hit that one much further in the air than I think he was trying to.
Mickelson will be next to play. Roger, you have a chance to look at the lie?
Well, the lie is down, Gary, but it's kind of a nest egg, and I think it's going to be very easy to judge how this ball comes out. I don't think it's as tough as it looks. And it's going to come out with very little spin and should just release nicely
the
on
uphill,
a bit of an upslope.
The uphill lie makes it easier, doesn't
That's
it?
Right, it makes it easier as well. He'll get some altitude on this.
This is where he earned his reputation.
Running there?
Yeah, I'm surprised at that.
Took a little dinky little swing, didn't he?
Yeah, he did. I'm surprised that. I would have thought he'd use that big swinging motion he usually uses.
Gary, you know the read here?
Well, John, I think Roger's right. It appears like it wants to go a little left at the start, but then it will definitely try to creep back to the right at the end. Tough putt to read. Over to 17.
Tiger heard that roar, Mark. Well, he had been watching very closely everything that was going on down at 16, so he didn't even get ready to putt before Payne did.
Left center putt, Mark?
I think it's left center, John. The green falls away to the back.
It's not a hard putt. It really isn't. Inside the hole, do it.
And yet another lip out.
Got it on the edge. He had to keep it inside the cup.
Hit it awfully firm too, Johnny.
He sure did. Just wasn't a lot of break. When you hit this hard, it's dead straight. I mean, you watch this. This is just tracking as straight as you can, down and in and out.
Much like the one at 11.
Wow, that's a shame there.
Back to 16.
Biggest putt of his life.
Yeah, just to answer Stewart.
Payne Stewart stretched this putt out some.
No, it's not going to move that much.
He yanked it.
Mickelson records his third bogey of the week at 16. And he and Stewart are now tied.
Well, Payne selected a 6-iron, John. Wind coming from the left.
How about that putt on the last hole?
How clutch was that?
Wow.
Well, he's got to just keep gearing up. Hole location's way back, right there. Back left center of the green.
He starts, shot starts just left of the hole, cutting just right of the hole.
Shot. Payne Stewart. And Phil Mickelson says, nice shot. Now he's got to gear up. He just had the championship, of course, with a shot lead, let that squander by the big putt by Payne. And
that's enough.
He wants to know if it's enough.
A little bit of help.
Is
like
it raucous out there, Roger?
Right now.
It's getting a little wild out here now, John. People are getting very excited.
What club?
This is a 6-iron as well.
He said, is it enough? I'm just curious if he's at the 6.
Excuse me, John, this is a 7. He's going to have to get all of it to get it back there.
He's jacked up. Get the hole! See if he can answer Payne's great shot.
Boy, this is going right in the same line as Payne's.
Oh, what a shot! You're kidding me! Woo!
And normally you would expect these players to hold these putts, except it is the 71st hole of the Open.
Phil pulled it on the last hole. Pulled it again. Just flat pulled it. He has a tendency to hood it going back. And both of those putts were pulled 2 inches. And Payne Stewart, you're in the driver's seat right now.
Disappointing par. Stewart a chance now. Take a 1-shot lead over Mickelson and 2 shots over Vijay Singh and Tiger Woods.
Roger, isn't it amazing what pressure will do to people? Just great stuff off the tee, though. Got to hand it to him. But this putt, not much there. Tiger Woods had a similar putt.
Well, it's all about steadying the nerves, taking a deep breath, trying to get your pulse rate down a little bit. Not easy to stay steady when all that's going on.
Tiger's got to dodge a serious bullet, and so does Phil right now. Straight in, Payne.
Stewart leads by 1.
Wants to hit it right there with a little fade into this spot there.
This ball going down the right.
right side. Should be pretty good.
No, it isn't. It missed by 6 inches, Raj, in the heavy stuff, and it went down. That is in trouble right there.
Chimes from the village chapel.
And they're playing Angels We Have Heard on High.
Well, he's going to need it right here because that cup is up high. Breaks to the right. That putt was so pure, it defies description.
Oh, agonizing.
That a great putt. Probably missed by an eighth of an inch.
A 70 for Woods. He challenged. And he's not out of it yet.
He's not out of it yet, but so many putts by Tiger Woods. Watch this, breaking right hard, dying, coming down in there. Well, it wasn't as close as I thought, but that was a heck of a putt. Couldn't see it too well, as you know, from our camera angle. But that was a super putt.
This was... Well, Woods was putting. Mickelson.
Perfect. Perfect. He's got a chance to catch Payne. Payne's got the tough lie.
The mist starting to come down more heavily now.
It looks more and more like a possible playoff with that tee shot. He's going to have to make a miraculous four here. The crosswalk is, of course, right. He wants to just hit it just past the crosswalk right there in that area. There's that crosswalk just in front of the bunker. Laid up just on the side slope there, the ball below his feet. Sort of a delicate little yardage. Seven iron farm or summer, eight?
This is a big seven iron.
He said, oh no,
it's all going right of the hole, John.
As the birdie chance.
See if it'll stay. It's going to go down into that low there. It won't go in a bad spot, but it should stop.
As the mist falls even heavier, the final two competitors walk to 18.
Well, it looks like pretty much a par by Mickelson, and it's going to have to be a heroic up and in for Payne Stewart. Otherwise, there will be a playoff. Roger, what kind of shot is it? One of those nervous shots?
Well, yardage very wise, nervous.
Yardage wise,
well,
I mean, are not bad.
Not bad. He's going to use his lob wedge, John, and he's going to try to land this ball probably some 15 feet short of the hole, maybe a little bit more, and let it take a hop and then skip and spin. This is the kind of shot that Payne's very good at. If it wasn't the 72nd hole of the Open, you know, you would expect him to get it very near the hole almost every time.
Cannot go long. About what you're supposed to expect in the United States Open. This putt, Roger, very slow, hard to get it to the hole. Moves to the left. How much do you think?
Well, I think once it gets across that slope, it's going to move pretty good. I want to see a little better than a foot or in that area.
Got to get it right out in here, Phil.
Too much.
280.
putt to win. Mickelson will finish his round. 16 pars today for Phil Mickelson. One birdie at 7, the bogey at 16. Just confirming how important par is. U.S. Open.
Roger, you can think about number 16, the phenomenal putt he held there, and what's he got here breakwise? Not too far from that fall line, is it?
No, there's not too much movement at all. I think it will move a little left, John, but it's almost improbable to think you could hold two putts like this for par in the last three holes, isn't it?
It is, and these uphill putts, you have to hit them so square and so perfect. There's no help. So the odds are quite good that there will be a playoff. And that'll happen tomorrow. But he's been here before. He's won this championship. He can do it.
Appears, Johnny, to be right on that emotional
Ladies and
edge.
Gentlemen, will you please join me in welcoming the 1999 United States Open champion, Payne Stewart.
Talk.
I was just gonna say, how do you begin, Payne, to put this championship, the moment you just realized a few moments ago, into perspective? Not only winning the Open for the second time, but in the storybook fashion you just pulled off.
Well, I have to first of all, I have to give thanks to the Lord. If it wasn't for his the faith that I have in him, I wouldn't have been able to have the faith I've had in myself on the golf course today. So thank you, Lord.
Payne, and the resiliency you showed today on the golf course, making all the big putts when you needed them, and of course the one at 18, but with what happened last year and the experience that, well, the scars were still there, we know. You've talked a lot about it this week. Everybody's asked you about it, but to win it coming off of that year.
Well, it's, yeah, I don't know that I know what to say right this second. Woo!
You said that experience made you tougher, and there were numerous times on the golf course today where you had to dig deep.
Well, I could never give up out there. Phil played unbelievable. He really did. And you'll win yours. You'll win yours. And I know Amy's at home, and I'd like to express to Phil and Amy that being parents is a special thing. And I'm glad that he's made the commitment, whether he got the beeper today or not, he was going to be there with his wife, and that's very special. And I was with my wife for both of my children, and it's there's nothing like being parents. And I think that Phil's gonna have his opportunities again. Mine might be on a short list.
To win a national championship and to win it for the second time, but you've talked about it also this week about dreaming to have the putt to win a U.S. Open. What was going through your mind when you knew you had to make it?
Well, I read the putt, and I said, it's even though it looks like it wants to go left, it's inside right. And I'm, excuse me, inside left, where did I play it? And I putted, I'd stroked the ball well all day long. I hit a lot of great putts, and I just said, give yourself a chance and do the. I went through the same routine I went through on every putt, and it went in.
Well, I'm going to let you gather yourself for just a second here, Payne. I do want to bring in Phil Mickelson for just a moment, Phil. Phil, a lot of people thought it would be your destiny this week. You arrived in town late Tuesday night. Your wife, Amy, expecting on June 30th, asked all week long about it. A lot of people thought this would be your first year to break through at a major championship. You dug deep out there today as well. Congratulations.
Well, thank you. It was an exciting tournament for me, and I had a great time today. I know that the outcome wasn't what I had hoped for, but I thought that the putts that Payne made on 16 and 18 showed what a great champion he is, and I think he represents the United States exceptionally well as our champion.
Before you leave, Phil, you've spent quite a bit of time apart from Amy. I'm sure you probably have a message to relay to her back in Scottsdale, Arizona.
Well, I just spoke with you, and I'm going to get home tonight, and in a couple of days, hopefully, we'll have our first child.
Congratulations, Phil. Well, back up to Dick Emberg.
Now, what is it about sport that makes grown men feel like kids again?
That was absolutely fabulous. You'd think Payne Stewart hitting 7 greens in regulation today on some of the toughest slopes you've ever seen and shooting level par, 24 putts today. There's never been a player that's made 3 putts of that length the last 3 holes to win by 1 in a major championship that I can remember. 16, it was over 20 feet. 17, the magnificent iron shot and a 5-footer there, and then that straight uphill putt at 18, which had to be hit perfectly to be made. You don't expect that out of anybody, especially a guy that's 42.
Payne Stewart is the champion here at Pinehurst No. 2.